Hey fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. Today I wanted to talk about the Fury racket I've been testing. I actually have two Fury rackets for test. I haven't strung up the other one. I have too much to go through, strings, rackets and whatnot. But I've been playing quite a lot with the Fury Arma Pro that's here. And it's an interesting frame, definitely a frame I've enjoyed hitting with and I've played some good tennis with. And it has a few characteristics that I want to get into straight away. It's kind of a boxy beam, which I like. So, and it's a more narrow head. So the boxy beam, as you can see here, reminds me kind of like old school frames, like a Pro Staff 85 or something like that. So it's a bit more boxy. Obviously it's a bigger head size. It's 101 square inch head size, but it has a little bit more of a narrow profile than power rackets, which is interesting and a probably good choice from the master racket technician that designed this racket together with the Fury guys. Has weight added here. They call it energy return technology. I'm pretty sure it's basically weight added for a bit more power and stability. And the specs are actually very, very nice, also for more advanced players. So this is the Arma Pro. It's 305 grams unstrung, 101 square inch head size, 1619 string pattern, 24 millimeter beam. An interesting spec. I strung it with their Poly C4, Fury C4, and got the following specs. 323 grams strung with the dampener and no overgrip. I play it without. Balance around 32.2 centimeters. That's around 6-7 points head light. And the swing weight 323.5, including the dampener. Beefier specs than what you see from most rackets these days. Most 100 square inch rackets and above are really light. Swing weight usually 300 to 310 strong. They're usually quite low in swing weight. So I was happy to see something that was over 320, which gives it a bit more stability, a bit more power. And the feeling of this frame is really nice. The sound and the feeling are the two things that really makes this racket stand out. It feels kind of old school, but offers ample power. And for most players, that would be a great combination. I did struggle with control at times, but I will try a few more string setups and see if I can rein that in. But overall, when I was, you know, adding topspin and feeling the ball well, this racket really performed excellently, especially on slices and volleys. I found that if I, you know, slice, come to the net, and then I had great feeling on the volley, stability and feel. So this racket kind of goes somewhere in between, more of a kind of old school performance racket, but then brings it to a bigger head size. It's quite a unique feeling frame, has a really nice sound, that kind of blend of old and new, which I think is great. I would love to try a smaller head size. I think the 101 square inch head size for me personally with the weight can be a bit much. Maybe the Arma Lite with some customization works better for my game, I'm not sure. But definitely a very interesting racket from Fury. And obviously with these new brands, new players on the market, you're always a bit skeptical because it's, you know, it's gonna all be marketing. What's the thing here? They don't have no really prior experience to designing rackets, and that's a tough thing. You need a lot of research and development to design a good racket, but it seems that they put in the work here and actually created something that's a little bit different to what you find from power rackets. They went pretty safe with the design, all blacked out, works for most players, I think, with some yellow accents that's in the Fury brand. But overall, the boxy beam and the combination of that extra power from the 101 square inch head size, it makes it a very interesting frame. Let's go through the different shots. Good on serve, good precision, and not super power, but decent power. Ground strokes, yeah, that's a good power there. Lacked a little bit of control at times. So you'd probably need to string higher depending on your technique. Volleys, excellent feeling, great stability, very, very nice on volleys. Nice to carve the slice as well. Really liked it on slice shots, as I said. It felt like it really performed there. and overall, like drop shots and stuff like that, it had a really nice sensation when hitting. So I think a lot of players should consider this. I know it's tough when you have this new brand, you can't demo and so on. So, but definitely a frame, if you're into a power frame, but you want something a little bit different, has a little bit blend of an old school and a new school, I think you should give these a try, because it's a nicely balanced racket that offers something for players who want a little bit of extra power and spin, but something slightly different that's pretty comfortable as well. The stiffness is very well balanced, you get the power, but you don't have that issue with any arm problems at all. I didn't feel anything when playing with this frame, which I can do even with the low tension, with the pure aero that I've been playing in recent videos. Still feel it, you know. So this one, definitely nothing, even with a full bed of poly at a 23 kilos 51 pounds. Well done, Fury. Like this racket, definitely for you guys who are looking into power, want some comfort, something slightly different with good feeling, good slice, stability. The Arma Pro has a little bit of more mass than most 100 square inch racket on the market, so it might be worth checking out. Very enjoyable frame, and I'm gonna keep using it, and I will update this review if something else pops up when I change to the strings and so on. Thanks for watching this review. If you wanna support the work I do, please join Patreon, patreon.com/tennisnerd. Check out my affiliates, the links are in the description below, and have a nice day, and don't forget to play some tennis. And please also subscribe to the channel, that helps a lot. Thanks. Good day.